that for myself. So I assume that the ANC caucus kept shape. I assume the parties that worked with us that I mentioned here voted for us. But for the rest, I don't know. Maybe the three are from the EFF and the three of the DA voted for the EFF. I don't know. So where the others come from, I don't know. I can't speculate. I saw in the news that they'll have a polygraph test. Let them have it. They'll conduct a polygraph test. Let them do it. And remember, this time there were three candidates and people were voting for personalities. They chose amongst the three leaders, all three regional chairpersons of parties that they've worked with over the last 3 years in council. So we came at tops and we appreciate it and we are very thankful. The issue of budget. I want to cross that bridge when we get there. In February, we'll be passing a adjustment budget. Now, we are not faced by the fact that we might not pass budget. We are confident that everyone will have a stake in that budget and that budget will go through. The threat that won't pass budget, for me, it's politicking. When we get down to the nuts and bolts, we'll be able to pass budget. 11 councillors by the SG, I think that's for national office of the ANC to answer. I am not aware and not negotiating with any DA councillor myself, even politically as a regional chairperson of Greater Johannesburg. City Power and all other entities, I said to the city manager earlier on that after the council meeting, we'll be having a session myself and himself to talk about all the concerns we raise and put a plan to turn around, especially City Power, Joburg Water, pick it up, because these are customer-facing entities that we think that must not collapse. City manager, suppliers not being paid on time. Oku, any one of you. Whoever is standing in the chair.
Thank you and congratulations, EM. The aim of this government is to pay all suppliers, big or small, within 30 days. The target is taken so serious that it is on my scorecard. I've also cascaded it to every person who reports to me. There are, however, very practical challenges affecting both big and small. Before we pay, obviously, we have to ensure that all documentation is 100% because we are audited. There are those invoices that will be found wanting. There would be invoices that the paying mentioned department will have questions, and this will unfortunately increase those times. It is not desirable, and we aim to improve that. You are aware that the city of Joburg is rolling out what we call the SAP upgrade project at a cost of just less than R1 billion, where we'll be having a SAP HANA installed the first time for local government. This SAP HANA will have e-procurement modules. These modules will obviously better the way we interact with our suppliers. We continue to train those suppliers that are micro and small, that we feel they might not understand how to complete the information. On the state of finances for City Power and other entities, there are very aggressive plans that we are implementing. For the buses, there is something that they call the automated fare collection system. Other municipalities have got it. We are lagging behind, but we are implementing it. For other services where cash is received, we are moving into cashless systems, also to make sure that our cash is okay. City Power, the big money spinner, we have already put meters that confirms the input points from ESCOM so that there isn't anybody robbing the other. We are investigating battery storage issues. We are working very hard to make sure that our meters are read on time. And if you look at the billing queries, some people say we are winning. On the water, if you have ever visited Riverside houses, you'll notice that we have now moved into a prepaid meter systems for water. Not many municipalities have moved that far. And you will recognize if you have been to Orange Farm that we are busy with designing systems that will reduce water leaks. Executive Mayor, I think I have covered the administrative issues.
Sure. Okay. Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, the executive mayor has just whispered. I know that I'm not honoring my commitment. Just whispered that there's a caucus that he needs to attend before going into council at 10. So we will end this press briefing here. And thank you very much for attending. There will be council happening for those colleagues that want to follow the council proceedings. And there will be opportunities during breaks and so forth to do one-on-ones. Thank you very much.
That the newly appointed mayor of the city, executive mayor of the city of Johannesburg.
We were very early, I know.
Mm-hmm.